you for this bridge 46. Here we are. And this is, we relieve the trucks on this 46 bridge.
This one we saw just now. This is after we do the works, relieve the trucks. This is where we are now. It's for this Akare station, before we relay the trucks. This is when we put the trucks on this station. And this picture, it shows we spring the ballast on this new truck. Yes, this one too. To Mina.
So this board, it shows some other areas. This one is the truck before we rotate of the truck. This is in Mukwa area.
This one too. And this picture, it shows us after we clean the bush. This one is from Jeba to Mukwa. We read the new truck. This is for the side injury. It's also in Mukwa.
This one is from between Mukwa to Akare. It's also the side rings.
This is rest and widen the embankment. This is in Mukwa. This one is true. And this is the level crossing before the recitation. And this one is renew the level crossing because the traffic is too much. So we do it in the middle night. This one is in Jeba. This one is after we renew the level crossing. This one is in Mukwa. This one is between Mukwa and Akare. Thank you, Barsa.
Cause they fill the open air and leave teardrops everywhere. You'd think me rude, but I would just stand and stare. I'd like to make myself believe that planet Earth turns slowly. It's hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep. Cause everything is never as it seems. Cause I get 1,000 hugs from 10,000 lightning bugs as they try to teach me how to dance. A foxtrot above my head, a sock hop beneath my bed, a disco ball is just hanging by a thread. I'd like to make myself believe.
Honorable Minister, sir, you are welcome to Akare. He has explained everything in the way you understand it. Actually, this thing occurred, flood occurred 3 years ago. Very devastating flood, which people around station, the old Akare was settlement was around station. They had to be relocated to where we showed you when we are coming on the road. Now, for the past 3 years, there has not been transit between north and south, as explained by the PRO. And the communities around here mainly depend on railway because is our main source of transportation. Our roads are bad, they are very mushy. So we solely depend on a railway. Now, after the construction, the communities here have two fears. One, that the river now, after the dredging, is incising, okay, towards this area. So as if with no long distance, it will wash away the land here, and then this bridge again will run into trouble. So we don't know what the engineers are doing. And then secondly, sir, where? Yeah, I'm coming to.
This is fourthly.
Fourthly, sir. Okay. Where we had the disembankment, where the river broke and washed away the other bridges, is linking us between here, Zungeru, Wishishi, Mina. Now, that place is also very, very bad. The community people are asking the constructor, the cousin, to please repair that damage. It's a little distance, you can't go there. You know, if not, you see this embankment place. So it's inaccessible now. And then thirdly, the local people are asking if the station can be moved from here to the new resettlement area.
An area that was completely washed out. It is an area which for a while, several years, has prevented a movement of trains from the south to the north. It's been the missing link, and I'm glad that we've actually overcome this problem. A lot of engineering design work went into this, and a lot of construction work has gone, especially the dredging, building of protection, the embankments, and reconstruction of the bridges. But with regards to the question that was asked by the gentleman about the protection of further flooding, I'll just let my project engineer handle that particular concern.
Let him just explain that.
Thank you. It's protective work. So we have plans to protect the north and the south embankment. On the south embankment, we are going to provide what we call drones. They are big boulders, stones, which we are going to line up all around like this and this way. That will deflect the water to come back to the center of the bridge, and also it will deposit sand. That sand will fill back that place which they are worried about. So on this other side, you can see we started, you saw some reinforcements. You saw some reinforcement coming out of the ground. We want to build an L profile. That L profile is to control, we call it retaining wall, is to control the materials, the fluid that have been excavated from returning back to the river. So all these two aspects of the job, it's been delayed until when the rain is over and the train start running, so that those boulders can be brought from the quarry. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have a question for the MD. When you say between this part of the country and the other southern part has not been possible, and when you say the problem is overcome, are you saying the strength services now between Akare and the southern part? That's what I want the MD to tell us.
Thank you very much. When I say the train, the problem is over, I think the proof of that is the ride we've just taken today. Ordinarily, we wouldn't have been able to cross with the train. Again, the good news for us is that it was actually just earlier on this week that the government inspector of railways actually certified the completion, the safe completion of this area, and it's by virtue of that certification that we're able to come here by rail today. It is by virtue of that certification that we're able to move the train all the way from Zungeru past this Akare. Ordinarily, you wouldn't have been able to cross this bridge. With regards to passenger and goods services, that is now the next step after certification. So what we're doing today is virtually launching train services over this particular area. Do you understand what I mean? Starting from next week, following on from there, we then introduce the extension of our goods and passenger services from Ilorin. You know, at the moment, we've been hearing a lot about Lagos to Ilorin. What we're doing today is a confirmation of the fact that trains can now move from Lagos all the way to Zungeru, which is where we started this trip. At the same time, we already have trains moving from Mina all the way to Kano. So the short bit that is left now is just a bridge which is being addressed in Mina. Once that is completed over the next 2-3 weeks, trains can now move from Lagos all the way to Kano. So that is how. Thank you very much.
Yes, appreciate it. Especially with the symbolic imports of linking the north and south by rail again. But it's also good that the minister said we should come to this spot. But I was just standing right by this bridge. If you give way small,
You see that this pillar looks like it has taken an impact. This one. So I don't know why it is like this. I'm just wondering what may have happened.
It will be addressed. It's likely to be construction damage.
The
excavator. It's even simple. At times when you have the dredging, the excavator bucket mistakenly hits that. So that will be addressed as a minor problem.
Okay.
Boys, here to you. This is a boo. Nancy, quite a bit of boo. The Lafayette, a trinket, and now got a year. What got it? Tamako, the Gaye. Ye lads, you are an affair of Lomina, Lodunguru, Lomoquana, ye de one. Sis are too much. Oh, aya, Matilla. That's a government, ye diabo. A fui in anama, can what you know, Gabi, where that what the fui. Ye waga, I'll de Tamako be. Brigia, boy.
That's a girl.
Then they were being in a bush of over to two one at honor.
Thank you.
That for the past 3 years or so, if they want to move from one location to the other, they use local transportation, hiring vehicles and what have you, and that has remained a very big challenge for them.
There are no vehicles here,
motorcycle and bicycle and what have you, and donkeys. And that they should fast track this project so that their life can come back to normal in a way that they can compete with other communities that
is now ready to take goods and passenger trains, which will now be moving all the way from Lagos up to Zungeru. Already, as we saw when we traveled to Kwara with this good governance team, we rode a passenger train from Ilorin to Ofa, which was moving all the way to Lagos. Now, with the confirmation of the Akare section of this rail track completed in weeks, the passenger trains will now be moving also from Lagos up to Zungeru, which is the birthplace of Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, as you all recall back. So this really is a major work here. You can see all the major bridges that have been built. Now there is a threat of erosion here, because you can see this river, Mariga, has been moving southwards and is displacing farmers and creating ecological problems here. And what the MD has told me is that they are going to do embarkation, an embankment on the southern bank of the river to stop it from eroding further southwards and return the river back to the center of this bridge once the rains are over. And this will ensure that the future problem that was encountered there 3 years ago, where the entire community was relocated, will be now controlled. So as we reassure Nigerians, this administration is sincere and serious about returning railway services. The MD has also reassured us that in the next few weeks, maybe between now and end of November, the last bridge between Zungeru and Mina will be rehabilitated, which means that before the end of this year, before Christmas time, Nigerians once again will have the opportunity, the masses of Nigerians will now have the opportunity to travel again from Lagos to Kano and Kano back to Lagos unstopped. And that will relieve the pressure we are facing on our roads, particularly between the north and south. And again, it will enable mass movement of goods and services and people between the north and the south. This is already being achieved, and so we are heading there. We will now be returning back on this train ride again to Zungeru, where again we'll be able to talk to you. If there are questions, we can wait until we go back to Zungeru. Thank you very much, indeed.